Where'd you get that gun?
Jude, look, there's a kid. Did you miss your ride? Did you, Phyllis? Now, you get that kid back on the bus. We're going to wake the others up.
I'm not going back. I'll get them out of the bus and I'll take it.
Oh, you can't, you dill brain. You shot a hole through the tire.
Then I'll hoof it. And I'll take along a little insurance with me so I don't get any funny ideas about trying to stop me.
Are you out of your mind? That's kidnapping. You have every cop in the country looking for you.
Just shut up. And don't come after me or the kid will get it.
You could have taken more time if you'd needed it, Miss Ferguson.
No, it's all right. My father's in good hands now. I've engaged a special nurse to take care of him.
Do you think the stroke could have been brought on by that ordeal you went through?
Apparently it is more than a possibility. There were no problems with my father's health before the kidnapping.
You can't let...
Cass! Cass!
Where the bloody hell is she?
Jude, that you?
Oh, hi! Oh. Oh, boy, am I glad to see you.
Yeah. Lost sight of Phyllis, but...
I'm not surprised. This bush is so thick. Still, it's best if the cops find her, I think.
Oh, I suppose. I just hope she doesn't hurt that little kid.
Oh, she's many things, but I don't think she'd hurt a little kid. Let's get back in that bus. We gotta wake those screws up.
Yeah, I suppose.
Where do we go?
Well... Geez, Jude, Not sure.
We couldn't be lost, could we?
Looks like it.
Well, let's go down that way, huh?
Righto. We might meet Phyllis and the kid, eh?
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
If we can't find our way out of here, how the bloody hell are they going to find us?
Oh, don't you go getting steamed up, Jude. Oh. I'm pretty good at looking after myself in the bush.
We've got to sit down, Cass. Yeah. Now, there's some comforts at home. Oh, my God. It's bloody rain, too. Yeah. There's water everywhere. Nothing to drink. I'm thirsty.
Yeah, it's too bad we didn't bring one of them little plastic cups off the bus. Never mind. You're going to have to suck a pebble.
Huh?
Yeah.
Oh, suck a pebble?
Oh, yeah. Stops you feeling thirsty.
I heard of getting blood out of a stone, but I never heard of getting water out of it.
Yeah, there you go.
Is this true?
Yeah, no worries.
Hope you know what you're talking about.
Anyway, I reckon we'll find a creek pretty soon.
I don't know, we could find a restaurant. I'm hungry as well.
Hey, haven't you still got that tucker we nicked at lunch?
I forgot about that. Ooh. It's squishy. I guess it'll taste all right, though.
I reckon we ought to save it till later, but...
Yeah, we don't know how long we're going to need it, do we?
And if we do meet up with Phyllis, that little kid's going to be getting pretty hungry about now.
Yeah. You're really worried about that kid, aren't you?
Yeah.
Well, you can stop worrying. I'll have a search party out by now.
Oh, you mean the cops? Oh, Jude, do you reckon we'll get into strife?
Well, I don't think they're going to greet us with open arms, do you?
Oh, jeez, I've really landed us in big trouble, haven't I?
No, you haven't, Cass. Bloody Reb's fault and Phyllis's. All you were trying to do was help the kid.
Yeah. Now, you reckon they'll believe that?
Probably not. It's going to get dark soon.
Yeah. I reckon we ought to keep moving, Jude. Try and find some place to sleep tonight.
Yeah, okay. Give us a hand up, love.
Oh, sure.
Oh! I nearly swallowed me pebble. I heard of gallstones, but that would be ridiculous.
So why marry him, for Christ's sake?
Yes. All right, Meg. I'll take it from here.
Something wrong, Governor?
All the women have escaped.
Ah.
I'll contact the police and... then I'll have to ring the department.
Won't be too pleased.
No, they'll probably have my head. Damn those women.
Thanks for the escort, love.
Yeah. Oh, sorry, any time, love.
Oh, well, I might have a free night tonight.
So Mrs. Reynolds just heard... What are you doing here?
God, I'd forgotten about you. It's funny how you only remember the good things, eh?
Well, no doubt you'll be back here soon. So you can refresh your memory.
You never know. You might be right, Miss Ferguson. You just keep that welcome mat out for me, won't you?
Looks like we found ourselves someplace to spend the night.
Oh, there's water in this tank.
Oh, yeah, but I wouldn't risk it, Jude. It's probably stagnant and full of dead frogs.
I don't care. There's a bloody dead horse in there. I'm thirsty.
Ah, no, no. Wouldn't be a dead horse in there. Jude, horse wouldn't fit. Oh, joke. Ha! Yeah, come on.
I wonder if they would consider it enough to leave the door unlocked.
Yeah. Hey, you reckon anybody would mind if we broke it down?
Well, we're already in enough trouble. I don't think it's going to matter, is it?
Yeah. Well, I hope.
It's not exactly the Hilton, but it's better than sleeping in a hollow log, isn't it?
True, true. Now, you want me to break this down, Jude?
Oh, I reckon I'll nudge it through it.
Yeah. All right. Oh! Oh, hey, Jude. There's an old mine shaft back there. Shut down now, but I reckon this shack must belong to the bloke used to work it.
Yeah, we're probably miles from any town.
Yeah. It's getting pretty dark, too. Hey, pity them lights don't work.
Well, look on the bright side. At least we don't have to look at what we're eating, huh?
Oh, yeah. Hey, I'm so hungry, bud. I don't reckon I'd care what it looked like. Oh. Mm. Hey. It sure feels good to be on the outside again, don't it? I mean, even if it is just for a little while, eh, Jude?
Yeah. I'll tell you what, though. If we try this again, let's stay at a nice, comfortable motel. This lumpy old mattress is going to make me feel like I've been through a ringer.
Oh, yeah. Now, look, don't you worry, Jude. I mean, we're going to find a way out tomorrow. Now, you have a good kip. You'll feel 100%.
Yeah. Hey, come on. I'm fine. Especially now I've had something to eat. Hey, wasn't that a good spread they put on for us?
Yeah, I'm sure was.
No further news?
No. It's just incredible. I mean, I can understand someone like Keane organising a stunt like this, but why the others went along with it is beyond me.
You're too trusting, Governor. You forget what these women are.
Yes, well, I doubt that I'll ever be quite so trusting again.
Look, why don't you go home and get some rest? I can take over here.
That's very kind of you, Miss Ferguson, but I'll be staying the night. Now, if that was all...
Yes, Governor.
Oh, just look at us, will you? Look at us. Here, let me get that straw out of your hair. You look like a tramp.
Geez, you're in a rotten mood. Get out the wrong side of the 80, Jack. Come on, Min, give us a smile. This is real ace.
If you say so, dear.
Where we go?
Go? We're going back to Wentworth, of course.
Why?
Let them know we haven't escaped, that's what.
But we have, haven't we?
Certainly not. We've just lost our way, that's all.
Well, they're not going to believe that. So now we're out, we may as well have a bit of fun. What do you reckon?
Oh, don't be ridiculous, Bobby. Mrs. Reynolds will be worried sick now. Come along, we're going back.
And they'll put us in the pound, and what have we done? Nothing.
You just listen to me, my girl. You were going to run away until I talked you out of it, remember? Now, come along. We'll be in enough trouble as it is.
Not going back, Min. Not yet, anyway, and you can't make me. The only reason you caught me yesterday was because I waited for you. Now, either you let me go and have a bit of fun or I'll nick off and no one will ever find me.
Will the police catch you? What is this? Are you blackmailing me?
Sorta. Oh, come on, Min, what do you say? Look, when we get back, they're going to throw the book at us, right? They'll reckon we're in on that escape. They're not going to believe us. Just one day, I promise, and I'll come back for you tonight.
One day?
One day.
You realise we haven't a cent to spend between us?
That's all right, Min, you'll think of something. You're the expert.
Oh, Bobby.